Welcome to this application explainer video, part of our data adapters topic range. In this video, we'll cover the subject of delete adapters within SLM. A delete adapter refers to a component or module responsible for managing deletion of data within the application. It often encapsulates the necessary logic and operations required to safely and efficiently delete the targeted data whilst ensuring data integrity. To utilize the delete adapter for removing objects, only three data elements are required for the deletion of each object: type ID, object ID, and the scope. To efficiently delete multiple objects, we utilize the delete adapter, which is located within the adapters module. These adapters operate with an Excel input file structure as follows. Type ID of the object, object ID of the object, and scope. The scope refers to the site's object ID where the object is situated. Let's go ahead and build the Excel file with the information of the two objects from two different scopes. In order to find the information for the type ID, object ID, and the scope for each object, we can click the light bulb icon in the Views toolbar. In there, we're going to find the object ID of the object, the scope and type ID of the object, and some other metadata and integration information. For this scenario, we just need these three elements, so I'll go ahead and copy and paste these into the Excel file. We'll also delete some equipment data, which is located in a different scope. So again, I'll copy and paste the required information into the Excel file. Once we've built the Excel file, we can proceed to the Delete Adapters feature in the Adapters module. Since we're deleting two objects from two different scopes, when we come to the channel, we'll select the master channel. The other channels are designated for processing data related to those specific scopes. Since in this scenario we're deleting data from two different scopes, we're going to use a master channel. We then press Select Files button and attach our Excel file and queue the task. We can check for the status of the task under Adapter Tasks and Delete Adapter Tasks. After the process is completed, we can verify that both objects have been deleted. The alarm under the first scope and the equipment under the second scope.